Hey there, today I am sharing things you do not need when you travel. These are items that you can leave at home. I will share items that you do not really need to pack, and this video is not only for those who overpack. We have all thought, you know, I might need that, so I'm gonna pack it. And then we never end up using it. So I will give you my list of things that I leave at home when I travel, and you make up your own decision based on your needs and your personality. Let's think about you touring Rome one day, and you left your rain jacket back at the hotel room and did not remember to check the weather forecast that day before leaving. So to help your forgetfulness, just pack a little 5-inch umbrella that they make now in the bottom of your travel bag or your backpack or your tote. They make little 5-inch travel umbrellas now, so just leave one of them at home, either the umbrella or the rain jacket. Until further notice, the Transportation Security Administration is allowing a full tub of antibacterial wipes as well as a 12-ounce bottle of hand sanitizer. But you can leave both of those at home and just pack 5 or 6 wipes in baggies and disperse them throughout your carry-on bag in your backpack or your crossbody bag. There are many sporting good items that are allowed in your carry-on or to walk through the TSA security line, and a lot of them need to be in your checked bags. But if you check the website and see that you might get a service charge for its weight or dimension, you might want to just leave it at home. For golf equipment on United Airlines, for example, you have to have the golf clubs and the shoes and the balls all in one sturdy bag. You may already know this. Same thing goes for a baseball bat. A regular baseball bat is allowed in your checked luggage only. But if it is larger or longer than a normal sized bat, then you would incur that service charge. You do not need to pack a big toiletry kit. Just pack your toiletries in different sized pouches that are a lot smaller and can smush and squish into those empty pockets of space in your suitcase. You do not need to take your original pill bottles when you travel. You can disperse those pills into organizers. You can put them in baggies and put them all around your carry-on suitcase or your checked suitcase. Just know that TSA will probably screen them, so they need to be able to get to them. You do not have to take out pills going through security, okay? Liquid medicines you do have to take out going through security and just put them in a bin beside your regular liquids bag. I have a video called Traveling with Medicines that will be helpful for you that I will list for you. And also I will list an updated article by the TSA, or you can just go to their site. Now, if you are traveling to Japan, I have heard that you cannot bring Sudafed there. So if you were traveling to Japan or somewhere near there, just Google what medicines are not allowed in China or Japan or somewhere like that. A travel blanket is something that you can leave at home. It is not a necessity for the airplane. Just pack a cardigan, a hoodie, or a scarf, and that can double as a travel blanket. Packing a power bank is a must, but do not only pack a single charging power bank. You want a power bank that can charge your phone twice. For instance, this happened to me. My phone battery was dead from going through the day, and then I charged it on the flight, and then I had to use Google Maps with my rental car, and so my battery in my phone was dying and I needed that extra charge, but my power bank only could charge my phone once. So I suggest a 2-time charging power bank. Mine has 5,000 something in it. I will link it for you. You do not need to pack a skateboard. You can walk through the TSA line with it. Just make sure with your airline that it is going to be able to go in the overhead bins or under the seat in front of you. And just remember that if it's larger than a regular size skateboard, you're gonna have that surcharge or service charge. And it also needs to be stored wheels up. You do not need to pack big down jackets inside your suitcase. Just stuff them in that outside pocket while you're walking through the airport. And then when you get on the airplane, you can just stuff it on top of your suitcase. I did buy a packable down coat, but sometimes you are going to a destination that you need a heavier down coat. You do not need to pack liquid shampoo if you can find like a shampoo bar. They just get kind of waxy and sticky, and I just don't trust my hair in certain climates, so I pack my little go-to bottle of shampoo. I know you can also buy a little bottle of shampoo when you get to your destination, or just use the hotel's shampoo. You do not need to pack a travel iron, even though they make them in travel size. All United States of America hotels have irons, and if you travel abroad, even in an Airbnb, they will have an iron for you. You can go down to the front desk and ask for it, then you have to take it back down to the front desk most of the time. But it's just an unnecessary item that you can leave at home. You can travel with Downy Wrinkle Releaser. It does have a strong smell, but it's not awful. And one subscriber's travel hack is to hang your shirt or whatever in the shower when you're taking the shower, and then use a curling iron to iron that spot, or sprinkle some water drops on the spot that's wrinkled and then use a curling iron. And speaking of curling irons, you do not need to pack one of those big, thick curling iron rod covers. Just pack a 100% cotton sock. You do not need to pack your electronic cords and hard shell cases. They are just too bulky of an item, just like a toiletry bag. You can also save space by just packing your cords in baggies or this roll-up cord organizer that can roll up or fold up. If you do not follow me over on Instagram, I share travel hacks and travel tips 3 times a week over there. One of them is to use a pink little curler to wrap your travel cords around. I have all different kinds of travel hacks that I will list in videos below for you. You do not need to pack high heels for that one fancy dinner unless you actually end up having space for it. Find another outfit that will have another shoe that goes with it. I think packing booties or a nice pair of sandals that you can actually wear with casual clothes during the day is more of a multitasker thing that you can pack. You do not need to pack those big emergency kits. Just pack Tylenol, Advil, and Band-Aids, unless you're going to a remote location. I do have a video with 2 DIY amenity kits that you can like just filter through the frivolous things that I've listed in there, like a fingernail file. That is an emergency. You also do not need to pack a fancy dress for that one restaurant night. Pack a nicer pair of pants or a really nice blouse that can be worn during the day with shorts and sandals, as well as with jeans or nice black trousers at night. You do not need to pack a passport holder. They are so cute, and it is a good idea of something to house a whole family's amount of passports in, but I would just use a money belt or stick them way down in your front pocket. I do have a video about 9 travel safety tips that tells you why a passport is safe on its own, as long as it's closed. I sometimes travel with this infinity scarf, and it has a hidden pocket for a passport. So that's another way that you could travel with your passport. You do not need to pack shoes in those shoe bags that are so cute. You can also just use a free newspaper bag or a trash bag from the grocery store or a shower cap. But the main thing to leave at home is all the extra shoes that you do not need. Only take 2 pairs of shoes in your suitcase, maybe 3 if you're packing really thin sandals or flip-flops. I do have a video for you called 6 New Packing Methods that I will link for you if that will help. If you're traveling to another country, do not pack fresh produce because it will most likely be confiscated once you land. If you are going to eat that food or snack on the airplane, it's fine. They do not check it until you get to the destination. You do not need to pack your regular sized wallet. Just pack a thin travel wallet. It can be RFID like this one, but you just want enough pockets for your ID and a couple of credit cards. If you are a gamer, I have a video for you about 2 very important travel tips that I will list. One item that you see in every airport store is a neck pillow, but you actually do not need to pack them for a domestic flight. If you are going on a long haul flight and are really going to sleep or need help sleeping, just pack a really nice neck pillow. This was like $39, but it attaches to the headrest and holds your head back while you're sleeping. But you don't need those for domestic flights. And you definitely do not need to bring your home pillow from your own bed. The germs that it is going to pick up will be awful. What we suggest is to bring your home pillowcase so that you have that home smell, and then also stuff the hotel pillow down in there and then fill it with the towels if it's not firm enough. You can even use that pillowcase as a packing cube to pack your clothes in until you get to the hotel. But leave that pillow at home for sanitary reasons and for bulk. If you have not hit subscribe, please hit subscribe and the bell beside it so that you will get an email once a week when I upload a travel tip video. My most important item on this list is you do not need to pack an outfit for every day. Just mix and match travel outfit pieces. I have an excellent video that shows you 3 ways to choose your travel clothes, and it is helpful for all kinds of learners. Just like a toiletry bag, you don't need one case for all of your makeup. They have hard shell ones too. I would just disperse them into different pouches. Maybe have one for your touch-up makeup on your on the airplane, but leave that bulky makeup case at home. You also do not need to pack or wear your tall boots. I have found that I get so hot on some airplanes, especially in the winter, that I want to take those boots off in the airplane, and they take up so much space down below under the airplane seat. I think traveling with booties is a lot easier, and they look really cute with outfits. They make so many different kinds. Also, the short cowboy boots I have traveled with, it just takes up less space. That's my whole reason. You also do not need to take a bag that does not zip. Like, this one has a snap, so I would recommend that one, and I have used it on two different vacations. It snaps really well, and it has a hook that you can squish together. But another reason you don't want to take a bag with no zipper is because the contents could spill out inside the airplane. And for peace of mind, you want a bag or a backpack that you can just kind of smush back under the seat with your foot and not worry about stuff falling out. One safety measure I have taken for a bag with no zipper, but it does have a snap, remember, is I pack a lot of my personal item bag items in pouches. And that way I know if something is going to fall out. All right, thanks again for visiting our worldwide community here. My hope is that I help you travel the globe without a worry in the world. Now that we are thinking about traveling again after the coronavirus, congratulations and have such a great vacation again, finally.